Imagine a car speeding across the road, except when taking a closer look, there is no driver, because it's an autonomous car. Autonomous reminds us of automaticity. Automaticity is the property of automatic beating of the heart. In the car, there's music playing from the stereo. The music is from a live opera, and the opera singer is singing in perfect rhythm. Rhythmicity refers to the rhythmic excitation of the heart. A normal heart beats in a perfectly regular rhythm, and the interbeat intervals are constant. There is a conductor conducting the live opera. From conductor, we have conductivity. The cardiac muscles conduct impulses generated in the heart. The conductor makes the opera singer go all out in his singing. His lips start to dry and contract. This brings us to contractility, which is the next property of cardiac muscle. Ventricular contraction enables the heart to pump blood into circulation, and increased contractility results in increased cardiac output. As the opera draws to its finale, the applause is overwhelming. The conductor and the opera singer are very excited about their success. Excitability is the ability of the cardiac muscle to respond to different stimuli. The cardiac muscle is an excitable tissue, like nerves and other muscles. Far away on stage, there is also an excited trumpet player at a distance. Distance brings us to distanceability. The trumpet player is so excited that he blows up the trumpet like a balloon. Distanceability is the ability of the cardiac muscle to stretch. This occurs due to the property of compliance, or simply stretchability, and helps in adequate filling of the atrial and ventricular chambers. As everything comes to a close, there's a final photo shoot. The photo shoot takes a long time, and the flash is also on for a long time, hurting the eyes. The light from the flash bends. Light bending. Physics. Refraction. From this, we have long refractory period. Refractory period of the muscle is the period during which it does not evoke a response, no matter how strong the stimulus is. The action potential of the ventricular muscle has a strong refractory period. The photoshoot concludes and everyone gets ready to finally go home. But what? One of the extras steals a Swiss watch? Extra Swiss stole? Extra Sis stole? In an experimental recording of a normal cardiogram, when a sufficiently stronger stimulus is applied during the refractory period, an extra contractile response occurs. This is called extra systole. As the extra bolts for it, the entire opera hall is shocked and stops everything they're doing. Everyone pauses, or for our purpose, compensatory pause. The natural stimulus falls in the refractory period of the extra systole and does not evoke a response. Therefore, the natural contraction is missed. This is why a long pause, or compensatory pause, is recorded following the extra systole. The security of the opera hall is immediately alerted of the theft. Reacting quickly, they shut all the exits and no one is allowed to leave. The cardiac muscles follow the all-or-none law. The all-or-none law states that the magnitude of response of a tissue to a stimuli remains the same, irrespective of the strength of the stimuli. Being the witty guy he is, the extra dodges all the security personnel and runs up the stairs. Now, we have the staircase phenomenon. If a quiescent heart is stimulated repeatedly, keeping the interval between the stimuli just less than 10 seconds, the magnitude of the first 3 to 4 contractions progressively increases. The security is one step ahead. They are on the upper deck too. The extra can't move forward or go back. He's surrounded on all sides. But that isn't the end for him. He spots a long, tense rope and quickly Tarzans onto it. The rope is long and tense, so it can take his weight and his loot. The force of contraction is directly proportionate to the length of the muscle fiber before the contraction, within the physiological limit, of course. This is known as length-tension relationship, or the Frank-Starling law. The security force is a tough match for the extra. They don't let him off that easy. They march in from the top. The security force's march drives the rope at a frequency. The frequency increases as more security force march in. Increase in force of contraction due to the increase in frequency, or simply heart rate, is known as frequency force relationship. It seems like it is the end for the extra. The rope can't hold on any longer and breaks. But wait, what? The extra takes the heavy load and Spider-Man swings onto the next rope? This gives us load. But the security start marching in onto that one too. Outwitting the security force once again, the extra starts Spider-Man swinging from one rope to another and breaks out of the opera hall through one of the windows. But just at that moment, the autonomous car is speeding across the road at a high velocity and crashes into him. So we arrive at load-velocity relationship. The relationship of velocity of shortening to the load imparted on the muscle with which it contracts is called load-velocity relationship. The function of the autonomous car fails to detect the extra and crashes into him. Okay, so finally, no more guys. I promise. It is the end for the extra. The unfortunate failure, or should I say, the fortunate failure, of the autopilot function is in perfect sync to stop the extra from escaping. This gives us functional syncytium. The cardiac muscle is a functional syncytium due to the presence of numerous gap functions, so all the muscle fibers contract almost simultaneously. The extra is nabbed by the security personnel, they hand him over to the cops, and everyone lives happily ever after, yada yada yada, you guys get it. So that's it, those were the 14 properties of cardiac muscle.